digestive enzymes. Enzymes are biologically active proteins that act as catalysts to help control and speed up chemical reactions in the body. Without them, these reactions would take a long time, and so enzymes are very important. But there are three different classes of enzymes: digestive, metabolic, and food-based. Today we'll be talking about digestive enzymes, which are the enzymes that are there to help us digest food. And so what are the benefits, the side effects? That is what we will be going through today. The importance of enzymes. It's a naturally occurring substance in all organisms, and without them, life is not possible. They are essential for these processes in the production of a lot of different types of foods, like cheese and bread and even fermentation. But enzymes are shaped in a way that allow other molecules to fit inside their hollow folds. And so when they bind or hook with other substances, they actually create new proteins. And thousands of new chemical combinations are able to work because of these enzymes. And they are a vital life force. And so a lot of organs also make different enzymes. For example, your pancreas actually is the one that produces most of your digestive and metabolic enzymes. We have to keep in mind that as powerful and efficient enzymes are, they are also fragile in that most of them cannot survive higher temperatures or lower pH levels. Let's look at digestion. Most of digestion starts as you put a piece of food in your mouth. Chewing, which is like mastication, releasing saliva, begins this breakdown process of food. Amylase enzymes in the saliva actually work on carbohydrates in your mouth. And then as it goes on into the small intestine, that's where it gets broken down even more. As food passes down to the stomach, protein is now being broken down by protease. And then the food goes into small intestines where fats are digested by lipase. You can see this trend that ACE can be an enzyme. And so once the food is converted into absorbable micronutrients, these micronutrients then pass through the small intestine walls into the bloodstream. And so amylase, protease, lipase are some of the main digestive enzymes, but there are also other ones like lactase, which helps with the digestion of lactose, sucrose, which helps with the digestion of sugars, maltase reduces maltose to dextrose, phytase overall helps the digestion and assists with B vitamin production, and cellulase helps with the digestion of fiber. There are many different types of enzymes for digestion, and if you are looking to help heal your gut and in order to absorb nutrients much easier and better, digestive enzymes are one way of being able to help with that. If you are having a lot of bloating, especially right after you eat, you might think about your stomach acidity levels, but also your enzyme levels, because lack of stomach acid and lack of enzymes to be able to help break down food can cause bloating right after you eat. So we talked about digestive enzymes, and there are other types of enzymes like metabolic enzymes. And metabolic enzymes are there to help the reactions in your bodies speed up, right? So it could be in any circulatory system or lymphatic or immune system or cardiac system. Anything in your body that needs a reaction can usually use these metabolic enzymes. Due to the decline in quality of most people's diet, especially in the standard American diet, that are low in fresh fruits and vegetables, we have to be more aware of digestive enzyme deficiency. Symptoms like that can be bloating, constipation, acid reflux, indigestion, cramping, and flatulence. And so when the GI tract is not functioning optimally, the immune system begins to suffer. And with lowered immunity, then you're more susceptible to disease and slower recovery time. So digestive enzyme can aid with energy conservation, as it takes more energy to digest food when you are deficient in digestive enzymes. And there are several ways to naturally help your enzyme production, like chewing your food properly, which helps produce more enzyme-rich saliva. Not chewing gum, because chewing gum actually produces saliva that is not needed and then depletes your enzyme resources without a good reason. Eating raw foods, like enzyme-rich foods like pineapples, papayas, avocados, kiwis, honey, and mangoes, they are very high in enzymes. Consider switching to unpasteurized milk. Add sprouted foods to your diet. Eat less and avoid processed foods. These are natural ways of increasing your digestive enzymes. The third type of enzyme can be called a systemic enzyme, where they are proteolytic enzymes or proteases, hydrolytic enzymes that help with the breakdown of proteins. They can include items like pancreatic proteases like trypsin, chymotrypsin, cysteine proteases, and other proteases found in fungi. These enzymes, which can be derived from cows or pigs, have been used in systemic enzyme therapy for over hundreds of years, and they've been mainly used orally for GI disorders, but they can also help to reduce inflammation processes, especially if they're taken on an empty stomach. And so they are different than digestive enzymes, because when you take it on an empty stomach, it actually helps to reduce pain and inflammation in the body. They can actually also enhance the immune system when they are taken on an empty stomach. So how do you choose your enzyme supplement? One of the first things to consider is the bioavailability of these oral enzyme formulas. One issue that can cause problems for oral enzymes is the acidity of the stomach, as enzymes are very sensitive to pH levels. So the formula usually needs to have a good enteric coating, and it seems that plant-based enzymes can withstand a larger pH range rather than animal-based enzymes. So the broader the pH range that the enzyme can handle, the better. So there are many different types of enzymes, whether it's bromelain, papain, pepsin, pancreatin, ox bile. Just make sure to choose a formula with high quality and knowing what you're trying to break down in your gut, and see whether it does help you or not. So we talked a lot today about the different types of enzymes, whether it's digestive, metabolic, and systemic. There are uses for each one of them. If you have any questions at all, definitely give us a call, and we'll be able to help empower you on this journey towards health.